لا حول ولا قوۃ الا باللہ العلی العظیم، اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، الحمد للہ الذی ہدانا لہذا وما کنا لنہتدی لولا ان ہدانا اللہ، لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق والصلاۃ والسلام علی النبی الامی الربی القرشی الابتہی التہامی سید البہی سراج المزی الکوکب دری صاحب الوقار والسکینہ المدفون بارض المدینہ الرسول المسدس المحمود الاحمد خاتم النبین سید المرسلین و مولانا و مولا الثقلین و جد الحسن والحسین و ابی القاسم محمد ولا آل بیت الطیبین الطاہرین المعصومین المظلومین ولعنۃ اللہ علی آدائہم اجمعین من یومنا ھذا الی قیام یوم الدین، اما بعد فقد قال اللہ تبارک فی کتابہ المبین وہو اصدق الصادقین، بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، قل لا اسألکم علیہ اجرا الا المودۃ فی القربا، ریسپیکٹڈ فرینڈ اینڈ اسلامک ریسرچ اسکالرس اینڈ اسلامک کمپینینس، before I deliver my lecture I would like to specify my topic, the topic which was given specified by Anjuman-e-Sultan-e-Aza, that is contribution of Ahlul Bayt, role of Ahlul Bayt, significance of Ahlul Bayt, importance of Ahlul Bayt to our material as well as its spiritual development. So in this majlis, before I deliver my lecture, before I translate the verse of Quran which I have recited, I think that most of you are well acquainted about this verse of Quran in which Almighty says that I do not ask you anything except association with the door of Ahlul Bayt, attachment with Ahlul Bayt, proximity with Ahlul Bayt, love with Ahlul Bayt, closeness with Ahlul Bayt. So in this verse of Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I do not ask you. So before I proceed, I would like to focus on the verse in which context it was revealed, where it was presented, where it was sent down. You know where it has been revealed? The book which is ultimate, which is final, which is sacred, which is sublime, which is ultimate. The book, the holy book in which the verse was revealed, it is ultimate, final, sacred, sublime. And if you doubt over it, you are out of Islam. If you so inshallah, I will try to put across multiple ideas, multiple perception, multiple perspective transmitted by Islamic intellectual and Islamic scholars one by one, and I will try to prove why Ahlul Bayt is obligatory upon us, why it is necessary to us to be attached with the door of Ahlul Bayt. And I will focus and I will provide substantial body of scholarship regarding contribution of Ahlul Bayt. So the verse of Quran which I have recited, you are familiar with, you are well acquainted, you are well aware that it is known as verse of love. It is Ayah Muwaddah. It is Ayah Muwaddah. Historical background let me focus on so that it may be more comprehensible and accessible to your consciousness. A group of people, a congregation of people visited Prophet asking the wage of prophethood. They said, Prophet, you have substantially contributed to our life. You have taught us about social dimension of life, political dimension of life, economic dimension of life. You taught us about moral dimension of life, philosophical dimension of life. You taught us about psychological dimension of life, economic dimension of life. You taught us about physical dimension of life, metaphysical dimension of life, material development, spiritual development. So there is no topic, there is no domain, there is no dimension, there is no subject about which you did not discuss. You taught us about Usul-e-Din, you taught us about Furve-Din, you taught us about tenets of Islam. Well educated intellectuals are sitting. The point which I would like to raise, that they said, Prophet, you taught us about tenets of Islam, principle of Islam, mandates of Islam, rules of Islam, regulation of Islam, morals of Islam. So several things you contributed that nobody can pay back. Prophet, we want to know, what do you want? Do you want any material pleasure? Do you want money? Do you want wealth? Do you want to occupy position? Then Prophet told that I am not from this material planet. I do not ask you anything associated with this material planet. And Prophet said, what he says. Then the verse which I have recited, it came down, it was revealed, in which Almighty says, O Prophet, O Messenger of humanity, O Prophet of humanity, O Leader of wisdom, O height of knowledge, O height of morality, tell them, intimate them, apprise them. I do not ask you anything. I do not demand you anything except association, proximity, attachment with the door of Ahlul Bayt. So there have been several disagreement and consensus as well. So first point is that we need to know that who are Ahlul Bayt. Second point is that why the love of Ahlul Bayt has been made obligatory upon us. When Ibn Abbas asked to Prophet, Prophet, O Messenger of God and Almighty, tell us, who are Ahlul Bayt? Prophet told, they are Ali, Hassan, Fatima, Hussein. They are Ahlul Bayt. Their love has been made obligatory upon us. You need to be attached yourself with the door of Ahlul Bayt. Okay, it is clear? Ali, Fatima, Hassan, Hussein, Panjatan, 5, 14 infallibles. They are infallibles who have been appointed by Almighty. Their love have been made obligatory upon us. Okay, look at the structure of verse of Quran. Quran says that Qul, it begins with the word Qul. Qul la salakum. I do not ask you. In the same way, when Almighty mentions about Tawheed, he says, Qul huwallahu ahad allahu samad. And when God mentions, begins about, when mentions about prophethood, he says, Qul ya ayyuhan nas, inni rasulullah ilaykum. So when God mentions about Tawheed, he begins with the word Qul. When God mentions about prophethood, he begins with the word Qul. And when God mentions about love for Ahlul Bayt, he begins with the word Qul. No, no, let me tell you in different way. When God mentions about La ilaha illallah, he says with Qul. When he mentions about Muhammadur Rasulullah, he begins with Qul. When he mentions about Ali and Waliullah, he begins with Qul. So three verses of Quran I recited in which Almighty begins with the Qul. Why? Because Almighty want to tell us that love for Ahlul Bayt is not equal to Furu-e-Din, it is equal to Usul-e-Din. So there are several, before I tell you why it is imperative, why it is essential, why it is necessary to be attached with the door of Ahlul Bayt, you need to know that there are several verses of Quran talking about Ahlul Bayt, talking about merits of Ahlul Bayt, qualities of Ahlul Bayt, attributes of Ahlul Bayt. There are several verses of Quran. Shawahidut Tanzil, it has been narrated. That is, I think, one of the biggest, one of the good documents about Ahlul Bayt, in which Ibn Abbas says that the entire Quran can be divided into four parts. First part is associated with qualities of Ahlul Bayt, virtues of Ahlul Bayt, merits of Ahlul Bayt. Please pay attention. And second part is associated with curse upon enemies of Ahlul Bayt. And third part is associated with lawful and unlawful activities. And fourth part is associated with responsibilities and obligation. It means at least one part of Quran has been revealed for Ahlul Bayt. Junabi ul Mudda, It has been narrated in that book that at least 300 verses of Quran has been revealed for Imam Ali, peace be upon him. 300 verses of Quran. You can ask how can you proclaim? Let me give you example. Let me prove it. When God mentioned about ilma falal bayt, knowledge of falal bayt, he says wama ya'lamu ta'wilahu illallah wa rasikhuna fil ilm. When he mentions about ismat, infallibility of halal bayt, he says innama yuridullaha liyusbanakum rissa halal bayt wa tahrakum tathira. And when God mentions about generosity of halal bayt, he says allazina yunfiquna amwalahum bil layli wan nahar sirran wa ilaniya. When he mentions about authority and guardianship of Ahlul Bayt, he says innama walikumullah wa rasuluhu wallazina amanu wallazina yuqimuna as-salata wa yutuna az-zakata wa hum raki'un. Salawat be jamaah. Allah shayna sana fi imam mubin. So it means that more than 300 verses of Quran have been revealed for Ahlul Bayt. Each and every verse of Quran is narrating quality of Ahlul Bayt. Why it is obligatory? Why it is imperative? In this age of globalization, in this age of postmodernism, there are multiple versions of Islam. Contrived version of Islam, fabricated version of Islam, simulated version of Islam, Islam of hatred, Islam of violence, Islam of discrimination, Islam of fundamentalism. For example, I am a non-Muslim. For example, I am a non-Muslim. I want to be part of Islam. I want to embrace Islam and I want to follow Islam. There are several versions of Islam. Hanafi version of Islam, Barelvi version of Islam, Shafi'i version of Islam, Sunni version of Islam. Which one is correct? Which one is right? How can I recognize? Which one is? So there is general concept and general idea that if you want to understand about Hinduism, you need to go to Gita, read Gita, it will be clear for you. And if you want to know about Christianity, you need to approach to Bible. But this is not idea in Islam. In Islam, Quran will not suffice. Quran is not enough. Because if Quran was enough, Almighty would have asked recitation of Quran, not attachment with the door of Ahlul Bayt. It was the reason. It means Quran will not suffice. For example, I am non-Muslim. I want to be Muslim. I want to be part of Muslim. I want to follow Islam. What to do? People will say, go and read Quran. When I recite Quran, there are several interpretation, several tafasir, several interpretation. Hanafi interpretation, Barelvi interpretation, subject to interpretation, modern interpretation, radical interpretation, Sunni interpretation, Shafi'i interpretation. So how can I recognize which one is right, which is one is ultimate and object to interpretation of Quran? How can we recognize? Ask Quran. Quran says wama ya'lamu ta'wilahu illallah wa rasikhuna fil ilm. It means the ability to understand Quran comes from the door of Ahlul Bayt. The ability to understand Islam comes from the door of Ahlul Bayt. The ability to understand Quran comes from the door of Ahlul Bayt. The ability to understand Injil comes from the door of Ahlul Bayt. The ability to understand Tawrat comes from the door of Ahlul Bayt. Anything. Because each and every verse of Quran is surrounded by multiple perception and multiple perspective. Who can teach you? The one who possesses the knowledge of Quran. The one who has knowledge of Quran. And Imam says that I know nahano rasikhuna fil ilm. Because only with Quran you cannot approach true version of Islam. It was reason Almighty made it obligatory upon us to be attached with the door of Ahlul Bayt. It was reason. It was logic. It was rational. It was philosophy behind this. Almighty know that Quran will not be enough. It will not be sufficient. That is why He made us obligatory upon us. He invited, come to the door of Ahlul Bayt. They will teach you about science, physics, chemistry, geographical dimension of life. Injil, Torah, Zubur, history. Any dimension of life, any branch of life, any discipline of life, if you are not able to understand, come to the door of Ahlul Bayt. Imam Ali will tell you, Imam Hassan will tell you, Imam Hussein will tell you. They will unleash the mystery of universe for you. They will tell you about heaven as well as on this planet. Regarding this planet, they will intimate you. They can give you answer of any question. Question related to heaven, question related to this material world, question related to spiritual world. That is why Umar ibn Khattab once asked Imam Ali, why, Ya Ali, whenever any question comes to you, you give answer without thinking, even you do not take time for the with you give answer, you do not contemplate, you do not ponder over, you do not kick around, just you give answer without thinking. Imam says, Umar ibn Khattab, what is this? He says, this is palm. Imam said, how did you give answer without thinking? He says, Yali, it is visible, it is evident, it is before me. Imam says, as this palm is visible to you, in the same way, the knowledge of entire universe is visible to me. So the ability to understand Islam, the ability to understand Quran, the ability to identify true and correct version of Islam comes from the door of Ahlul Bayt. They are nahnu rasikhuna fil ilm. Almighty mentions about their virtues. Sometime He says they are Ayatullah. Sometime He says they are Sabilullah. Sometime they says that He says that they are Wajhullah. Because they possess knowledge of Quran, and the ability to understand correct interpretation of Quran comes from the Ahlul Bayt. Any dimension of life, my topic was why it was obligatory upon us to be attached with the door of Ahlul Bayt. Why it is necessary? What was the reason behind this? Because they can teach you about social values, political values, moral values, ethical values, civilizational values. And they can provide you knowledge of anything which you want. There is no leader on this planet who can give answer of all questions except Ali. Who claimed Saluni, Saluni. Ask anything which you want. Anything which you want to be acquainted, you can come and you can ask Ali. Ali will tell you. That is why Almighty made it obligatory upon us. He knew, He was aware that if we attach ourselves with the door of Ahlul Bayt, we will be able to reach the true version of Islam. The correct Islam is with the door of Ahlul Bayt. There is correct Islam. Okay, so if you want to know about administrative system, social system, political system, judicial system, economic system, and how to survive and how to pass your life, come to the door of Ahlul Bayt. They can teach you. They can intimate you. They can apprise you. And you can give, because there is a paucity of time. One aspect, as far as governance of Imam Ali is concerned, let me tell you some important aspect about this. Because there is a paucity of time, so I will just deliver some important aspect of governance. Imam Ali wrote a letter to Malik Yashtar. Says, Malik Yashtar, I am sending you as a governor of Egypt. And I am sending you certain parameters. On the basis of that, you can run your governance. If you want to achieve good governance, follow these guidance. Follow these instructions. This is universally proclaimed, appreciated, endorsed, acknowledged message and guidance to entire humanity. This is not only message to Malikya Star, it is message to entire universe. Follow some point, just think of it, contemplate, ponder over it. Imam says, oh Malikya Star, when you go, you will find two types of people. Those who are brother in faith, those who are brother in humanity. Some people will be from your religion, some people will not be from your religion. Malikya Star, keep in your mind, do not forget, there should not be any discrimination on the basis of religion, on the basis of caste, on the basis of creeds, on the basis of beliefs. There should not be any discrimination. Now people are talking about discrimination. Now governments are talking about discrimination. And Ali told at that moment of life, before 1400 years, Ali told there should not be discrimination. Malikya Star, keep in your mind, poor cannot reach you, but you can reach poor. Malikya Star, bridge the communication gap. Try to have direct communication with poor, with subject. Because if you have conversation with them, you will be really to know, you will know about the problem and issues of them. Then you will be able to achieve good governance. It will help you in policy formulation. Malikya Star, third point, accept constructive criticism. If somebody says this is not right, think of it. Do not say that you are right. Accept constructive criticism. Tamiri tanqeed, constructive criticism, accept. If somebody suggests you, if somebody recommend you, if somebody make correction in your policy, think of it, accept it. Malikya Star, keep in your mind, your system should be marked by transparency and accountability. Coward people should not be part of your system. Miser people should not be part of your system. Corrupt people should not be part of your system. Because they will harm you and your system. Malikya Star, remove negative thought. Never think negatively, think positively. Malikya Star, do not accept favoritism. Do not foster it. On the basis of relations, do not appoint anyone. So there is each and every topic about governance Imam Ali mentions. Poor cannot reach you, you can reach poor. Have a direct communication with them. Protect your environment. Think of poor, think of middle class. Should not be discrimination on the basis of classes of society. Do not accept invitation of aristocrats. So each and everything Imam Ali mentions. And if you want to achieve good governance, follow instructions, guidance, rules given by Imam Ali. Now entire globe is talking about sustainable development. And sustainable development is possible with the attachment of Ahlul Bayt. If you follow this letter, definitely you will be able to achieve good governance. The good governance Imam Ali mentions about. In the same way, when you study life of Imam Hassan, you will get multiple things. And when you study the life of Imam Hussein, you will get multiple things and you can put into practice. Just keep in your mind. Always make constructive programs. There should not be discrimination between what you act upon and what you say. If your desire is on right path, it is constructive. And if your desire is not on right path, it is destructive. Imam Hussein alayhi salatu salam, he is a part of Ahlul Bayt, member of Ahlul Bayt. Our third Imam and leader appointed by Almighty, the creator of universe. He appointed. And he taught us about social values. He taught us about relations between people. And he taught us about how a social system should be, how a political system should be, how to attain rights while being oppressed and suppressed. Imam Hussein left Medina to preserve Islam, to save Islam. I always say, when you come to this place in gathering in Majlis, this is not only place to mourn, this is also place to learn. This is not only place to weep, but this is also place to seek, to learn something and implement in your real life. You need to put into practice each and every lesson and teaching of Ahlul Bayt. Imam Hussein alayhi salatu wasalam sacrificed his family to save Islam, to promote teenage and principle of Islam. He left Medina, he reached to Karbala only to save Islam, only to preserve Islam, only to send out, spread the message of humanity. Imam left Medina. Because these days are associated with Imam Muhammad Baqir alayhi salatu wasalam, I will discuss about something about Imam Muhammad Baqir alayhi salatu wasalam and Bibi Sakina. I will mention, in Karbala, Imam Hussein sacrificed each and everything. Akbar passed away, Qasim passed away, Aun passed away, Muhammad passed away, companion passed away. Imam Muhammad Baqir was present in Karbala. He saw from his own eyes when Akbar was martyred, he saw when Qasim was martyred, he saw when Aun was martyred, he saw when Muhammad was killed, he saw. When Qasim was martyred, he saw. When companions were martyred, he saw. From his own eyes, Imam was present. He was looking. He was watching entire Karbala taking place. May God bless your tears. Imam was present. He saw everything taking place in Karbala. How companions were oppressed and suppressed. How Akbar was killed. How Qasim was killed. How Aun was killed. How Muhammad was killed. He was there. And Bibi Sakina was there. Both were 4 years old around. Both were present in Karbala. Both were oppressed, both were suppressed, both were tortured, both felt pain and went through pain, both were chained. But one thing I would like to say with folding hand, Ya Imam Muhammad Baqir, you are oppressed, you are suppressed, you are tortured, you are chained like your aunt Sakina, but you came back to Medina. But your aunt Sakina couldn't back to Medina. She wanted to go back. She wanted to go back. She wanted to meet Shughra, but she couldn't come back. Still in prison of Zindan, in prison of Sham, he weeps. Her soul cries and says, "Oh my dear father, Sakina is still captive. Sakina is still in prison. Everybody left me alone. I am in Sham. I am in prison." Ala lanatullahi ala qawmi salimi. May God bless your tears. Jazakullah. Matame Hussein.